Hello friends, welcome to my channel Learning Electronics. In this video we are going to solve one numerical related to transistor characteristics. So before starting the video, please subscribe my channel and also press the bell icon so that you can get more updated videos from here. So the question is, if alpha is equal to 0.98 and VB is equal to 0.7 volt, find resistance R1 for I is equal to minus 2 milliampere. We have to neglect reverse saturation current I0 here. So the circuit is given in this figure. We have R2 is equal to 20 kilo ohm, RE 100 ohm, RC 3.3 kilo ohm and VCC is 12 volt here, and here we have for the transistor three currents will be there, that is I is equal to IC plus IB. So accordingly we are assuming the current directions, and we have assumed through R2 I2 is flowing and through R1 I1 is flowing. So I1 will be equal to, by applying KCL at this node, I1 will be equal to I2 plus IB. So we can find out IR, and in this node C I1 and IC is dividing, so IR will be equal to I1 plus IC. So from circuit diagram, IR will be equal to I1 plus IC, that is collector current, and I1 is current through R1. Now I1 is IB plus I2, so this will be equal to IB plus I2 plus IC. This is our equation number 1. So this is IR value. The current flowing through resistance RC is IR. Now here the ammeter current I is given minus 2 milliampere. That means the current direction will be opposite to that of assumed in this circuit diagram. So the current direction is given like this. This is I, minus 2 milliampere. So if we assume the current direction in the downward side, then I will be plus 2 milliampere. So we will take plus 2 milliampere here from the circuit in which we have assumed the current direction. So I will become plus 2 milliampere. Now we know that IC is equal to alpha I. We have alpha. Alpha is 0.98 into I is 2 milliampere, means 2 into 10 to the power minus 3. So we will get IC is equal to 1.96 milliampere. We will get 1.96 milliampere is IC. And we know that for the transistor, I is equal to IB plus IC is there. So from this equation we can find out IB is equal to I minus IC. IB is equal to I minus IC. This we will get. Now we put I's value. 2 milliampere is 2 into 10 to the power minus 3 minus IC is 2 milliampere. IC is 1.96 milliampere. So 1.96 into 10 to the power minus 3. So from this, IB will be equal to 0.04 milliampere, or it is equal to 40 microampere. So this is the answer for IB. So we have found out IB now. Now we apply KVL. Apply KVL to R2 base emitter to ground loop. So this is the loop in which we have to apply KVL. So we are applying KVL, so we get this is the loop direction is in this direction, and the current direction assumed in the downward direction, and the loop direction will be upward direction. So we have to take plus sign here. It will be plus I2R2 minus VBE minus IERE is equal to 0 we will get. Now VBE value we know 0.7 volt. So we get I2R2 is equal to VBE plus IERE. VB is 0.7 plus IE is 2 milliampere, 2 into 10 to the power minus 3 into RE is 100 ohm. And we can find out I2 from this equation. So divided by R2 is 20 kilo ohm, that is 20 into 10 to the power 3. So after solving this equation, I2 we will get 45 microampere, or it is equal to 0.045 milliampere we will get. This is I2's value. Now to find out this R1 value, we have to find out the base to ground voltage. So this is base to ground voltage. This is taken as VBN, base to ground voltage. So VBN is equal to, actually this VBN will be 2 across R2 only. So this is VBN. So this is equal to I2R2. It will be equal to 45 into 10 to the power minus 6 into R2. R2 is 20 kilo ohm, 20 into 10 to the power 3. So after solving, VBN is equal to 0.9 volt we will get. So this is VBN value. Now if we want to find out R1 value, so what will be the R1 value? The voltage at this point minus the voltage at this point divided by current through this resistance R1. So let the voltage between collector and ground is VCN. This is plus minus VCN, and this is plus minus VBN. So VBN we already found out. So R1 will be equal to, since the current direction is in this direction, from collector to base, so R1 will be equal to VCN minus VBN divided by I1. That means VCN minus VBN divided by I2 plus IB. So these currents we have already found out, VBN we found out, we have to find out VCN. So for this we have to apply KVL in the output side. Applying, let this be equation number 1. So apply KVL to output loop. So this is our output loop, starting from VCC to ground endpoint. So this will be equal to 12 minus IR into RC, means IR into 3.3 kilo ohm minus VCN is equal to 0 we will get. So VCN will be equal to 12 minus IR into 3.3 kilo ohm. So IR we have to find out. IR is equal to, this is equation number 2, IR is equal to IC plus IB plus I2. So we have IC is 1.96 milliampere plus IB is 0.04 milliampere plus I2 is 0.045 milliampere. So this value we will put here in this equation, we will put, so we will get VCN is equal to 12 minus 1.96 plus 0.04 plus 0.045 into 10 to the power minus 3 into 3.3 into 10 to the power 3. This we will get. So after solving, we get VCN is equal to 5.25 volt. This is VCN. Now put this in equation number 1. VCN value we will put. So we will get R1 is equal to VCN minus VBN divided by I2 plus IB. So this is equal to 5.25 minus VBN is 0.9 divided by I2. I2 is 0.045 milliampere plus IB is 0.04 into 10 to the power minus 3. So after solving this, we will get R1 is equal to 51.176 kilo ohm. So this is the value of R1 which we are getting from the circuit diagram. So it is approximately equal to 51K. So hope friends you have understood the topic. Thank you very much for watching and please do subscribe my channel for more updates.